What up, guys, and welcome to the finale of Season 1 of My Team Career Mode. We have so much packed into this video, including Season 2 plans, and of course, the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix. But first, I want to take again another moment to reflect on the season. It's been some highs, some lows. We took a win at Austin, which was down to strategic genius and luck. And it's not what I would have expected for my first season. I didn't expect to take a win or even take two podiums at all. So it's a positive start. And next season, we're aiming to take even more race wins. If we can take maybe two or three race wins, that would be fantastic. And maybe look at targeting the championship for season three. We have a long-term plan. It's going to be a long road, but I'm confident that we can achieve our goals. Right, that first lap was something dire, so we've gone to take a second lap in Q1, and again, it just wasn't enough to get us through. So on our third lap, we just have to dig deep and find something truly special to try and get us through this first part of qualifying. Other teams have clearly bought upgrades and brought their A game to go out on a bang for this finale. I'm hoping we can do a similar thing as well, but it's going to be difficult starting from 15th.
Welcome to the Yas Marina circuit for the finale of another thrilling Formula One season. It's been a breathtaking year, and we end it at a track that's been the scene of many glories and heartbreaks over its history. It's time to end the season in style. It's time for the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix. The Yas Marina circuit, just over 3.4 miles long with 21 corners and two very long back straights. There are two DRS zones going into the heavy braking zones of both Turn 8 and Turn 11, and offer plenty of potential for overtaking. The circuit comes with its fair share of tricky corners as well, in particular 15, 16 and 17, which will certainly test a driver's braking management. And I'm joined once again by Anthony Davidson to bring you the lowdown for today's race. Why don't we start by talking about Valtteri Bottas? What a season they've had. A well-deserved championship victory, and the pressure now surely off with the title already in the bag.
It really is well-deserved. I wouldn't say it's been a faultless title challenge, but certainly one that has been consistent and well managed. Here's hoping they let off a bit of steam today and give us an exciting race.
With the race minutes away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Valtteri Bottas lines up on pole position, and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Leclerc, Ricciardo, Carlos Sainz, and Perez. Kvyat, Gasly, Albon, they've taken a grid penalty. And Lance Stroll, Ocon, Vettel, Lando Norris, Oldtimer, Verstappen, Raikkonen, Antonio Giovinazzi, and Kevin Magnussen. Schumacher, Russell, Latifi, and Romain Grosjean sits at the back of the grid. And now, it's time to head down to the track.
Well, this is it then. The final race of the season. We are starting P14 thanks to a penalty. And it is lights out and away we go for the finale here. We've got a decent start. We're trying to have a look up the inside of Vettel already, who I think has also had a penalty. We're taking a very timid dive up the inside. Banging wheels with Vettel, that's not going to help us. And in fact, Vettel has got past and we've gone a little bit wide out the second corner there. And we're now trying to make it up the inside of the chicane, covering off Lando Norris. We have covered off Lando Norris, and we've made a little bit of contact with Vettel. We're going to try and go around the outside here, and we're hanging that outside line, and Vettel coming across a little bit there. That's a bit rude, Seb. That's very rude. Don't appreciate that. Right, we're down the straight now, and it's going to be a drag race between us and Vettel, but that Ferrari engine with superior power helping him through, but we're going to try and break that a little bit later and go round the outside of him. We've made that move stick. Next up is Stroll. And a few cars ahead of us are actually battling it out quite furiously, as you would normally expect on the first lap. And we're trying to make as many positions as we can. But we haven't got the run on the straight, actually. But we're going to go round the outside of Stroll here And that is a very decent move there. And now we're looking at Albon for P10. Diving up the inside. Taking that place off of Albon. Good move there. We're trying to move forwards as quickly as we can in this race. This is going to be a long, long race. As we now try and line up Ocon. But I think we're not able to get past in that sector. And in fact, Gasly and Ocon are gone at this point. They have checked out. And we're now starting to develop a little bit of a train as our pace around here is not fantastic at all. And that's putting it mildly as we've now got Albon and Vettel all over our gearbox that we've got to try and keep behind. And Albon's going to be close enough to have a look. Is he going to take the look here? No, I don't think he is. No, he's going for it last minute. He's going down the inside. We are now going to cover the outside here. We're covering the outside. He's still alongside us. We're still wheel-to-wheel going into Sector 3. Albon not giving this one up easily at all. We're going to take the inside for these fast corners here. But we've now gone deep. And Albon coming back up our inside. And we've gone. He's gone through. But we've got the better exit. We're now still side by side with Albon. And Albon's still there. Not giving this one up. And Albon's still on the outside. Just back out of it, Albon. You're not coming past. We force him to back out and we spent the entire sector free will to win. Albon's still not getting the message. He is still not getting the message as he tries the outside. Back out of it, Alex. You are not coming through, sunshine. Nuh-uh. And in fact, Albon, I think, has made for the pits. And now we've got Stroll coming past us. Giving us a bit of a headache there. But we cover Stroll off there. Quite nicely. Whew, I need to catch my breath a bit. That was an intense couple of corners there. Or should I say an intense couple of laps. As we're on lap 7 of 28 now. And in fact we do make our first pit stop on lap 8. Oh dear, I need to catch my breath. That was some intense wheel-to-wheel action there with Albon. And then Stroll coming at us as well. And we have got an entire train of cars that we're trying to keep behind us. We've made our first of two pit stops in this race. Going on to medium tyres, and we've dropped back quite significantly as a result. But the other guys who are in front of us are on soft tyres, should be pitting soon. And there is Max Verstappen in the other Red Bull, so he appears to have come out of nowhere there. And we're now going to start challenging Verstappen for 17th place. Words I never thought I'd be saying, unless it was about Jos Verstappen in the classic games. But we have made our way past Max there. For 17th, and he's going to come straight back at us at some point. There is an inevitability that Max is going to come back at us. He is not going to let that one go easy. Magnussen and Latifi ahead, but they, I believe, need to make their pit stop. So, oh dear, we exceeded track limits a bit there. That's not good. Right, Verstappen now coming straight back at me. I've gone to the inside to defend. Max is going to go to the outside. Hopefully I should still have the line, the inside for the corner. Albon's having a look as well, which is why I'm trying to keep the inside on Max, but I've locked up and I've gone deep, and that is going to allow Max to come straight past. And now Albon, is he going to have a look? No, he's not entirely close enough yet. If anything, he's got more stress of Norris behind him to be dealing with, so we should be relatively safe for now, but I don't trust Albon to not come back at us in a split second or a lap. Bottas setting the fastest lap. So Bottas, even though he's won the championship, he is still going for it. There is still all to play for from his perspective. And now we've got Norris on our right. We've got Albon on our left trying to go for it as well. We cover Norris. And, well, Norris getting a bit rude there, but we keep him behind. But that's until the next lap. We've got Albon and Stroll now getting involved. Albon not wanting to give this up at all. We give him about the width of an F1 car. He goes for it and we bang wheels. And that has actually done a little bit of damage to me. So we're going to be running a little bit compromised here. Although the damage doesn't look that bad. I can feel the damage. So Albon coming back at me. Is he going to go for it here? No, he is not. Me and Albon just getting very aggressive there. This is getting serious. This is getting very serious. And now we've got Lance Stroll going past us. And we're going to try and keep the inside here, which we do. A little bit of contact, but we still hold on to this P11. I've never fought this hard over a position there isn't a points-paying position in my life. And some cars have made their second stops now. Stroll not giving up. Oh dear. This has been an action-packed race, and Bottas is now retiring from it. The championship winner out of the race, and we've got a virtual safety car, which just inconveniently ends as we pit. And we take on a new front wing because of the damage that we sustained earlier in the race. And we're now down to P19 with Grosjean and Mick Schumacher ahead of us with some catching to do. So unfortunately we have been passed by both Red Bulls and indeed some of the other cars that we were fighting. But we're going to fight on and see what we can make from this race. There's still a few laps to go. We're now closing in on Grosjean. Closing. We're going to take a dive up the inside here. And in fact, that is a pretty smooth move. We have got that done quite nicely. Collision with Grosjean! A, rubbish. I didn't touch him. And B, who cares? It's Grosjean. He causes devastation most races anyway. Right, we are now going to try and scythe our way up the inside of Mick Schumacher for 12th. And, well, there was some aggressive wheel banging to get him out the way there. But that was the move done. That was one for pride more than anything. Lewis Hamilton winning the race. And that's my way of thanking Mick Schumacher for his services. Or should I say lack of this season. Because, once again, it is a pointless race to finish a pointless season for Mick. I'm not giving him a second chance for season two. I'm sorry, Mick, you are fired. You are gone. I would get Alan Sugar to deliver the news, but, you know, he's busy being a billionaire. But for us, it's P12, and it is a non-points finish in a disappointing end to what has been quite an extraordinary season.
But they can go into the winter with their heads held high after an emphatic victory here today. And talk to me, what do you think it was that sealed the win for them?
Well, I know it's a bit of a boring answer, but the truth is they simply had the best speed package on the day, and a driver who knows how to take advantage of that. It doesn't matter how much time you spend poring over the stats and planning strategies if you can't keep the pace. And our winner today showed they could do both.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team. And they certainly deserve it. Top of the championship has been cut down.
Well, that's it then. The Abu Dhabi Grand Prix, it's all over. Hamilton won with Leclerc in second and Carlos Sainz getting the final podium of the year with Ricciardo and Kvyat and Gasly also placed quite high up as well. They had some pretty OP performances this year. In that race even, should I say, Kvyat had some strong showings in a few of the other races as well. But there's the final championship positions and we have held on to 7th in the standings, Ricciardo getting quite close in the end, and Albon a long way ahead of us. But we have held on to P7, and we've held on to P6 in the Constructors, no thanks to Mick Schumacher and his non-efforts this season. Right, so before we go into the Season 2 plans, once again, it is time for the final highlights reel of the season.
Turn back time.
it then. That is the conclusion of season one. We have got a nice bit of team acclaim for the final race. And we've got a good cash injection there from our sponsors. We, for some reason, didn't get the one from DSB Optics. No thanks to not getting a top 10 in that race. So we've now got a nice hefty amount of cash that we can splash. Ooh, poetry. But we are going to be saying goodbye to Mick Schumacher. Unfortunately, the lack of performances just isn't enough for us, you know. I want my number two driver, if you can even call it a number two driver. I want my teammate to be right up there with me and challenging me and sometimes beating me, you know. That's what I want from a teammate, and that's what I've not been getting from Mick. But obviously, we're still on a slight budget as to who we can take. So, what I want to do is take another F2 driver and build him up and see if he can give me some challenges this season for season two. We've decided to go with the relatively fast Antoine Hubert for season two. And, yeah. Will he accept our offer? The offer is accepted then. Antoine Hubert is officially our teammate for season two. Thought it'd be a nice touch bringing him to F1 as well, given everything. And I feel like he would have been a great F1 driver had he made it. So you know what? Let's give him a chance because, let's be honest, he's probably a right side more useful than Mick Schumacher was this season. So yeah, there we go. The final payments of the season. We're now going to finish off the season and accept our prize money and our sponsorship money as well, because we've done everything Shark has asked of us, and we should get some prize money for our constructors finish as well. But first, our overall acclaim for the rest of the season and all the good stuff as well. Just waiting on the money boost. We've moved up to level 15 of the combined acclaim, and we are going to get a nice bonus from Shark and an even nicer bonus in prize money for the season. So we have got a hell of a lot of cash that we are going to splash for season two. I need to stop with the poetry. TV Bub Poetry Corner. That's an old reference. I don't know if you'll get it, especially with me singing it like that anyway. So let's reveal what we're doing for season two. Then we're going for an all new sponsor, which requires 100 Constructor Championship points, which is fair enough. We're also saying goodbye to Honda for Season 2 and moving over to some nice OP Mercedes engines. And straight away, we're going to invest in some points for Antoine Hubert. Right, let's reveal our Season 2 livery. Look at that bad boy. My friend called it a discount Campos racing livery, but I quite like it. That is our Arrows F1 Season 2 livery. Look at that awesome wind tunnel. We've got awesome goals for Season 2. Thank you for watching Season 1. And until then, it is goodbye from me.